Haglöfs Åre Extreme Challenge is presented by Haglöfs. Outstanding outdoor equipment since 1914. Specialized makers of bicycles and accessories since 1974. At nature.com, everything for sports and outdoor life. And Vildmarksmässan, the Swedish outdoor show.
The competition format multi-sport reached Europe and Sweden in the mid-1990s and is nowadays established as one of the most popular adventure sports. The Nordic Alpine sports capital of Åre is buzzing with life and activities this time of the year, building just in time for the climax of the Haglöfs Åre Extreme Challenge, this year's stage for the 19th consecutive time. In total, the athletes will cover more than 70 kilometers of kayaking, mountain running and mountain bike cycling in the magnificent mountain setting in and around Åre. The athletes, comprising of more than 500 in the classes, duo, relay and solo, are heading for the start. And for the very first time, the prestigious solo class also doubles up as the Open European Multisport Championships.
It's already existing one in the original race in New Zealand, which they call Open World Championship. So we wanted to create the European Championship and to attract more foreign people to come and race here in this unique environment which we have here in Åre and the fantastic course.
The strong Team Haglöf Silver is back for the race in Åre. Among them, last year's winner, Robert Lindberg.
Well, my expectations are pretty high. As always, it's a beautiful race, a lot of nice views and stuff like that. But to win, you have to have a really good day. You have to be strong in all the disciplines, and you have to have a little bit of luck.
All the classes begin and paddle the entire kayaking leg in Lake Åre-Sjön this year, rather than the original course, which also runs in the rapids in the river Indalsälven. The water level in the rapids is far higher than normal, and the decision to change the course is based on safety for the athletes.
It's not the difficulties in the white water, it's more if you capsize, you can be caught in a tree and drown. And the water temperature is about 6 degrees. It's going very, very fast if you end up in the water.
We now see the start of Haglöfs Åre Extreme Challenge 2015, with the mountains Åre Skuten, Rian Fulet and Mulfulet embracing the lake, three magnificent backdrops. The start is split into two fields, of which the first to go is the solo classes of the European Championships. These are the classes we will follow. The 20 kilometres or so kayaking leg begins to the east and rounds the buoy just south of Åre Björnen. Quick to the lead is strong kayaker Joakim Lindberg, heading the paddling athletes back towards Åre. The solo classes athletes lists in this year's edition of Åre Extreme Challenge include some of the strongest names ever, especially among the women.
For me, it's the hardest thing going to be the kayak session. I think I'm going to lose some time on the. There are some really fast girls on the water, so I need to have really good legs to go uphill.
Oh, the competition has never been as hard. From what I've known, and so this year everyone has to have a really good day to be able to get on the podium.
It's going to be tough, Normally I race for 3 or 4 days, and now it's for 6 hours, so I'm really looking forward to see where, how it's going to be.
Coming in for the lift at Lakeside or Strand, we still have Joachim alone out in front. In the second group, accompanied by specialist kayaker Danny Holmian, we see New Zealander Sam Clark, an athlete who's travelled to Sweden with great ambitions.
Yeah, it's a really beautiful place to be. The mountains running straight out from the lake. It's going to be a very challenging course, but I'm really looking forward to the race. Well, I know some of the competitors here through racing over in China, and I know some of them are very strong, but well, second at Coast to Coast this year, and well, I'm here to win. I'm here to try and win, and I'm going to give it everything I have.
Hannes Sterner leads the third group into the lift, and here we see some of the top-ranked athletes in the men's class, Robert Lindberg and Emil Dahlqvist. In the strong women's class, the first out of the water is Christine Larsen, followed by last year's winner Caroline Holmqvist in second place.
I know I have to perform my absolutely best in all three disciplines just to be on the podium. I have to focus on just having fun because I know then I will perform better.
Well, it's going to be a really hard race this year, I think, so I need to have a good competition, no mistakes, and catch a good wave on the paddling and the general where I have my strength, it's on the bike. Even if I'm a little bit behind when we get out on the bike, I think I can take it in.
Previous multiple winner Josefina Wikberg is third at the lift at Åre Strand, with Mari Nielsen following in fourth. After re-entering the water outside the holiday club, the kayaking leg aims towards the west upstream of the river Indalsälven for the turning point at the Tiergeforsen Rapids. The weather in the fells is volatile, and in previous years' races, strong gusty winds causing high waves across Lake Åreskjern have caused problems for the athletes. But luckily the weather today is calmer and the competitors can make good speed. The leaders are now making their way downstream and towards the exchange for the start of the running leg. After roughly 1 hour 30 minutes of kayaking, here we see specialist paddler Joachim Lindberg reaching the shore in a strong lead. Danny Holmian and Sam Clark follow approximately 7 minutes behind. Mattias Nyström, Robert Lindberg and Emil Dahlqvist coming in as 3rd, 4th and 5th respectively, trailing by another 4 minutes. Christine Larsen, competing for Ad Nature, has done very well in the kayaking leg. She comes in for the exchange in the lead, less than 10 minutes behind the group of male athletes that are heading for the overall victory. Running up through Central Aura, we still have Caroline Holmqvist in second place, 2 minutes further back from Christine. Long distance specialist Marlin Hjalmarsson is third up the stairs. And here are Josefina Wikberg and Mari Kreisander, fourth and fifth, 12 minutes behind Christine in the lead. Still to come for the athletes is 15 kilometres of running, more than 1,000 vertical metres uphill to the summit of Mount Åreskutan.
The 2015 year Haugnes Åre Extreme Challenge will be kind of special. We have never had this much snow on the course, and it's about 2 meters on the top, and it would have been good to have skis here, but we have forbidden that. So it's a running section still.
Peter Gustafsson and Morten Burstrand are in the heavy section of Top Bakken above Central Aura, on their way up into the Bear region and the Summer Trail. Sam Clark is now in the lead, and all the favourites have now caught up with and passed Joachim, who won the kayaking leg. The northbound summer trail to the summit means that the ground changes from slopes covered in grass, heather and clay to a gradually tougher terrain with rocks, boulders and steeper elevation. And the snowfields keep growing bigger and bigger. Previous multiple winner Bjørn Rydvall is struggling uphill. Young and promising Rikard Norlin, last year finishing in 10th place, is doing well and keeps up among the leaders. We see Simon Niemi, Team Peak Performance, advancing towards the summit. Christine Larsen demonstrates great form, keeping a devastating pace uphill at Mount Aureskuten, at 1,420 metres above sea level. Josefina is a strong runner, and without pole, she's gained minutes on Caroline Holmqvist and has overtaken Marlin Jalmaschen, who's now in fourth. The mountain scenery becomes panoramic over Aura Mountains for the two male athletes in the lead at halfway. Sam Clark, Thule Adventure Team, is just overtaken by Robert Limber, Team Haglöf Silver, at the Summit Cafe after 2 hours and 38 minutes of the race. Emil Dahlqvist, Swedish Armed Forces, and Mattias Nyström, Haglöf Silver, both 2 minutes off the lead. Bjørn Rydvall, Haglöf Silver, has climbed up into fifth place, and young Rikard Norlin is now at the summit in sixth place. After her magnificent acceleration to the summit, Christine Larsen has now added another 3 minutes to her lead in the women's class, and overall is a mere 14 minutes behind the best male athletes. The mountaineers on skis still refuse to pack their skis away, happily cheering on the brave athletes in Haglöf's Aura Extreme Challenge 2015. On, the running course continues to the north, slopes downhill to the village Huzo, and then the concluding cycling leg. Christine Larsen, Team AdNature, leads the women's class, and here, 5 minutes behind on the way to the Summit Cafe, is Caroline Holmqvist, Thule Adventure Team. Josefina Vikberg, Haglöf Silver, is in third position, cheered on by mountaineers on skis. Mari Nilsson, Team AdNature, now in fourth at the summit, right in front of Marlin Jalmaschen, Swedish Armed Forces. The large and deep snow fields on the back of Mount Aureskutun are now becoming less prominent, gradually giving ground to mud, grass and soon also birch tree forests. In Huzo, the point of the next exchange, the villagers instead call this side of the mountain the front. The group in the lead, headed by Robert Lindberg, has already reached Huzo, and his teammate of Team Haglöf Silver, Mattias Nyström, runs in a second. Emil Dahlqvist, Swedish Armed Forces, is in third place, with Sam Clark from New Zealand in fourth. All the athletes in the leading group exchange within a few minutes of each other. At the point of the course where the fir forest takes over, the athletes cross historical grounds. The Bjelke's copper mine with its Klondike years in the 1700s and 1800s. Here on the old trail where copper ore was transported down to the smelting house in Huzo, many of the athletes are more focused on the 30 kilometers plus of cycling ahead. Christine has completed a marvellous run across the mountain and added to her lead on Caroline, who's still in second position. There's 7 minutes between them at the Alpine Piste and the Café Groove Backenskrug. And still Josefina is in third in the women's class. The cycling leg, the third and final, takes the athletes back to Aura and the finish line at the square. The leg stretches for more than 30 kilometres on mountain bikes in highly varied terrain, starting on gravel and tractor roads eastbound from Huzo. In a very short time, the course gets wetter and very heavy across marshland and wet trail intersections. After the first steep uphill run to the second highest point of the course changes into drier single tracks, and wonderful views await the athletes over the large Lake Kalschern. The distance up to Kristin in the lead has shrunk dramatically during the first part. Cycling is Caroline's strongest discipline, and here at the clear-cut forest just before Freya Gruvar, she's just a few minutes behind. The old copper mine at Freya Gruvar is another of the heritage sites that the course runs past. The leading male athletes have now reached Aura Björnen and the second long uphill ride. Jari Palanen, who came out in 22nd position after the paddling leg, has put in a tremendous effort and climbed up to 6th position. The quartet in the lead, Robert Lindberg, Mathias Nyström, Sam Clark and Emil Dahlqvist, have been battling within minutes of each other throughout the cycling leg. And they're still at it when bursting towards Aura and the final heavy uphill climb, followed by the downhill runs into Aura Bike Park. Robert, accompanied by his teammate Mathias of Team Haglöf Silver, has managed to build a gap, and both of them arrive at the same time at the final climb. Still, Robert Lindberg is a little stronger and crosses the finish line with a smile on his face, rising to defend last year's title in Haglöf's Aura Extreme Challenge, the men's solo class, with a time of 4 hours, 53 minutes and 46 seconds, and now with the additional title of European Multisport Champion. Mathias Nyström follows across the line a mere 11 seconds behind. Roughly 4 minutes later, New Zealander Sam Clark of Thule Adventure Team reaches the finish at Aura Square in a fine third place. Emil Dahlqvist of Swedish Armed Forces finishes as the fourth best male athlete. Jari Palanen, Team Unique Scott, has advanced further and takes fifth place. Bjorn Ridvall, Team Haglöf Silver, finishes sixth in the men's solo class. Simon Niemi, Team Peak Performance, comes in seventh. Strong cyclist Frederik Edin puts on a late spurt and takes eighth place, just before 20-year-old talent Rickard Norlin, who puts in another strong performance in Aura Extreme. The men's top 10 list finishes with Fredrik Ringström coming into Aura Square after 5 hours and 19 minutes. Here is Caroline Holmqvist, Thule Adventure Team. She's managed a very strong cycling leg and overtakes Kristin shortly before arriving in Aura. Now, after 5 hours and 38 minutes, she's in position to safely grasp victory and the title European Multisport Champion Ladies Solo Class. And with it, her third consecutive win in Haglöf's Aura Extreme Challenge. 4 minutes later, we see Kristin Larsson, Team Adnature, in second place after a very well-executed race. Josefina Wickberg, Haglöf Silver, finishes third this year. Long-distance specialist Marlin Hjalmarsson, Swedish Armed Forces, demonstrates that she can also compete in multi-sport solo sprint, securing a well-deserved fourth place.
It feels great. It was a hard day. The paddling was okay. I just took it easy and followed the leaders. And then I tried to push uphill and got the lead just before the top. And then Mathias was just 1 minute behind all the time, so I couldn't really relax. But when I finished the downhill, and it was like 2Ks to the finish, I knew I should win. So. That's a nice feeling.
It's a lot harder than I anticipated. I felt really good on the kayak. I'm very familiar with kayaking. I felt great on the first section of the run, but then I hit the snow and I really just didn't know what to do. This is very beautiful. It's one of the most beautiful race courses I've experienced. The mountain, the lake is beautiful. The mountain biking trails were absolutely fantastic. So much fun. 10 out of 10.
It was really hard this year. It was crazy. Kristin is really strong in the paddling, and I had a really bad start and almost got flipped. You know, I just lost everybody, so she was before me, and then I know she's a really good runner. So I think I had 7 minutes in Huso when we started the bike, and I just biked like hell.
It was really hard for me because I've been chased by Karo, the whole biking section. And I know her very well, so I know how strong she is on the bike. So it was hard, both in my head and in my legs.
but it was a nice finish with the bike. It was nice and warm.
Haglöf's Aura Extreme Challenge 2015, a multi-sport race in duo, relay and solo classes, is an event that the athletes, the supporters, the spectators and the local Aura residents will remember for years to come. First year with the status of Open European Multisport Championships, a mountain running leg across the peak on extraordinary ground, exciting head-to-head battles in both the women's and the men's solo classes, mud, pain and joy, all the way to the finish line on the square in Aura.